Let's not bring that up.
We never forget the weekend.
Yeah, I guess not.
I guess
they
not.
Never let you forget.
I don't know.
Bob Doherty is in a different pool. He is here though. He's in 12 or 14. There's no AP photographer in this pool, to my knowledge.
I thought we were going to get
to it. Meet him with
the just a little bit back until he comes in.
Wonderful. There you go.
All right. So I got to practice a little.
Can you?
Regan and
Chris.
Look at these.
Yeah.
How are you?
Mrs. Rod.
President. Say, Mr. Wallace. Mr.
Wallace.
Royal Highness Prince Mohammed brought the aforementioned of Brunei Darussalam and the Royal Highness Pangeran Anak Istri Pangeran Anak Zaria. His Excellency Tengku Ahmad Ritorin, Foreign Minister of Malaysia, and Madam Tengku Nuraini. His Excellency Danabalan, Minister of Foreign Affairs of Singapore, and Madam Danabalan. His Excellency Air Chief Marshal, Deputy Prime Minister, and Minister of Foreign Affairs of Thailand, and Madam Selective. Foreign Minister and Mrs. Mokhtar Kusuma Al-Majad. Sesuai pemilihan Datuk Paduka Haji Jaludin bin Pemilihan Muhammad Imbang anda saudara of Brunei Darussalam Madam Datin Hajah Sama Binti Haji Hussein. Sesuai Cik Konsei Sao anda saudara of Singapore and Madam Konsei Sao.
Can you come back?
Sesuai Cik Rongpet Cucan Kun anda saudara of Thailand and Madam Cucan Kun. Sesuai Datuk Haji Muhammad Khatib Abdul Hamid, Malaysian Ambassador, and Madam Datin Nurul Khatib. Coordinating Minister for Security and Political Affairs, and Mrs. Suwarman. The Minister of State Secretary, and Mrs. Sudarmono. The Minister of National Planning, and Mrs. Sumarli. The Minister of Home Affairs, Mr. Rusta. The Minister of Post and Telecommunications, and Mrs. Tahir. The Minister of Trade, and Mrs. Rahmat Khaled. The Minister of Communications, and Mrs. Ruslin Mujani. The Minister of Information, Hamoko. The Minister, Cabinet Secretary, Mujuna. The Minister for Domestic Production, and Mrs. Nanda Kartasasita. Governor and Mrs. Mantri, Ambassador and Mrs. Sushila Sudharma, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces and Mrs. Udani, Commander of the Udayana Military District and Mrs. Rajabubu, Director General for Political Affairs and Mrs. Nana Sukhetna, Director Secretary to the President and Mrs. Sokka, Director General for Protocol and Mrs. Julia, Secretary General of ASEAN, Director General for Economic Affairs and Mrs. Atmono Surya, National Secretary of ASEAN and Mrs. Gusteru, Director General for Tourism, Mr. Abhi, Director General for Communication, Adnan, Director General for Research and Development of Foreign Affairs and Mrs. Asangari. Director General for Information, Mr. Sukarno.
Oh, wow.
That's it.
Please be seated.
khususnya kembali kami tangani kepada yang punya hubungan yang punya persidangan sekarang ini memang sangat singkat. Namun hal itu tidak dapat mengurangi arti penting yang kita letakkan bersama pada kunjungan ini. Arti penting dari kunjungan ini mungkin kita rasakan setelah saya dan yang mulia bersyukur masalah-masalah lingkungan maupun masalah-masalah internasional. Kunjungan yang mulia bersyukur sekarang ini bertepatan dengan keadaan dunia kita yang menghadapi berbagai masalah yang berat, pelik dan rawan, baik ditinjau dari segi keamanan maupun keamanan. Keadaan tadi di sebagai negara besar mempunyai kesempatan dan kemampuan untuk memberikan sumbangan yang sudah sangat maju atau yang sedang membangun, yang kaya maupun yang tidak kaya, untuk bekerja sama bahu-membahu sebagai dalam rangka inilah yang mulia Presiden, saya memandang saya berharap agar konferensi tingkat tinggi di antara negara-negara ini juga memperhatikan kepentingan dari semua bangsa, semua negara, semua masyarakat, masyarakat yang mengenai dua ini selama 3 hari berada di Pulau Sulawesi. Akhirnya, perkenalan saya mengajak perhatian kalian untuk mengangkat gelas dan minum bagi kesehatan yang boleh.
Year-to-year conduct of relations between fast in providing ample food resources is another indication of your government's effectiveness. The attainment of rice self-sufficiency is just one indication that Indonesia's economic development program has been wide-reaching and impressive. This program of growth and advancement has been directed toward bringing the benefits of development to all levels of society. President, not too long ago, you said it is impossible to reach equity in development, impossible to wipe out poverty if there is no economic growth. Well, we have brought that emphasis. We have a saying in the United States that rather than talk about how to divide up a small pie, let's work and build and make a bigger pie so everyone can have a good start. President, we've been happy to cooperate with you in a number of social and economic fields, including food production, all farm employment, private sector development, and healthcare. We look forward to continuing our work together. In this regard, we found the growing cooperation between our two nations in the field of science and technology to be particularly beneficial. Indonesia is also to be congratulated, Mr. President, for its humanitarian policy of granting first asylum to almost 100,000 refugees from Indochina. The international community and American people applaud Indonesia for its generous response to the plight of these unfortunate people who are seeking freedom and refuge. Many of these refugees have also resettled on our shores and have enriched the fabric of American life. These friends in distress is very important to Americans. I want to express to you, Mr. President, my personal appreciation for the sacrifice and consideration your government has shown in this humanitarian effort. I am struck by how our discussions have reflected the mutuality of interests and harmony of views. I am confident the spirit has prevailed here to enable us to forge even stronger relations in the years ahead. And I would ask the world to join me there in trusting the people of Indonesia, the distinguished leader, President Suharto, and the friendship between the Indonesians.